Earth's energy balance is an important aspect of weather and climate. It shows how the energy of the Earth, the energy of the atmosphere, must be in a balance, or it will get too cold, or it will get too hot. And here are two scenarios: Earth's energy balance there are two scenarios. Scenario one, and then finally scenario two. Two scenarios that they must be here in order to show that balance, or it will get too hot, or it'll get too cold, either way. All right, so let's look at this. We'll look at scenario one. Earth's energy balance, scenario one. Let's pretend that we have a block of ice. We have a block of ice here, which represents the polar regions. We have insulation, and I'll go ahead and put this here, insulation. What happens when you have ice and insulation hits it? Well, you have a high albedo, and that reflects, that radiation reflects off that surface, the high albedo surface, and so we have outgoing shortwave radiation, okay? Outgoing shortwave radiation. Therefore, there is high albedo, low absorption, and a low temperature. Okay, so insulation comes into the through the atmosphere, hits the surface that has a high albedo, such as ice, low absorption because it's high albedo. It reflects that solar radiation back out into the atmosphere, or even into space, and then we get a low temperature at the surface. So we keep the temperatures low. Now, if we just had this, our Earth would be completely cold all the time. We'd have ice all the time. So this is scenario one, the cold version. Now we go to scenario two. Down here at the surface, we have some trees. We have a house or a structure of some sort, and more trees. Okay, so now we have, at this point, we know that's the opposite. So we go ahead and put low albedo. And if you have low albedo, what is the absorption going to be? Well, it's going to be high absorption. And if you have high absorption, then you have to have a high temperature. So low albedo causes high absorption, which then results in a high temperature. So let's see how this works. All right, we have insulation, and I'm going to abbreviate it here. Insulation, IN, hits the surface of a low albedo. Therefore, you have high absorption, and then you start to emit long-wave radiation. Well, in this case, from the surface, we have outgoing long-wave radiation. So that's heat. It then gets into the atmosphere, and then there is another point of absorption. Now, this is not a cloud. This is definitely not a cloud, but it is the concept of the greenhouse gases, GHGs, the greenhouse gases, the greenhouse gases. Greenhouse gases encompass dust, air pollution, CO2, methane. Also, water vapor is another type of greenhouse gas. Anything that absorbs heat, retains it, and then re-emits it. Okay? So this is a point of absorption. So now we've got absorption. We're creating more heat here in the greenhouse gases. We've got two points, two locations that the long-wave radiation is going to go. Greenhouse gases keep it within the lower atmosphere, so we have incoming long-wave radiation, and also we have to release some out into space, so we get outgoing long-wave radiation. So the scenario two, is basically the warm portion of the Earth's energy balance. If we, with global warming and the climate change that we're experiencing now, that this is more heavy, this portion or this scenario is more heavily weighted than this one, okay? When climate change is done and we reach that threshold of going back into an ice age, then this is less weighted and this becomes more weighted. So it becomes more cold, okay? And we'll definitely investigate this further on in the later video lectures. So in order to maintain a balance, you have to have some radiation that is not absorbed by the surface of the Earth. It has to be released as outgoing shortwave radiation, okay? On the other side of this, you got to have some long-wave radiation heating the atmosphere or to get too cold. So you got to keep this balance. And how it balances out is that you have outgoing shortwave radiation and you also have outgoing long-wave radiation. It's very important to have these two components working to release some heat out of the atmosphere or it'll get too hot. Okay, it'll definitely get too hot. So let's go through this one more time. Scenario one, you have insulation that comes in through the atmosphere, a surface of high albedo, which results in a low absorption of energy, which then results in a low temperature, because there is now a reflection of that shortwave radiation going out into space. Scenario two, you have insulation that gets absorbed by the surface because it's low albedo, and low albedo results in a high absorption, which results in a high temperature. That temperature then is emitted by outgoing long-wave radiation. It's absorbed again by the greenhouse gases, which then it re-emits back to the surface as incoming long-wave radiation. And at the same time, you have outgoing long-wave radiation so that you can release some of that heat. Now, the best time to release a good amount of heat during this time, for this scenario, would be at night. At night with clear skies. Clear skies, a high pressure, at night will release a lot of long-wave radiation. Also, winter is a perfect time to release a lot of that outgoing or that long-wave radiation, a lot of that heat.